This is Key Point here on TV3. We're live on TV3 Ghana on Facebook, DSTV channel 279, all across the world on 3news.com. We're also live on 3FM 92.7 and also KESME 107.1 in Tamale and a number of radio stations across the country as well. Now, quickly, let's round up with the issues in Parliament, because this week, Alexander Afenyomakin, before he was announced as the majority leader, withdrew some 15 amendments that he sought to be considered to the anti-LGBTQ plus bill. Now, what does this withdrawal of this amendment mean to the passage of this bill by Parliament? And then also in terms of the timing of all of this. And how is this bill, if passed, what's going to be the process when Parliament finishes its job before we think about even implementation of this bill passed into law? Now, this is what happened in Parliament this week. Take a look.
I have proposed in the letter that the two flag bearers for the 2024 elections be engaged by the sponsors.
Now, you called on the House to do second consideration stage on some clauses of the bill. We now cannot go back to stakeholder engagements and all those things. There is no such rule in our practice. So you are completely out of order. Please, actions speak louder than words.
That's the speaker on the promotion of proper human sexual rights and Ghanaian family values, commonly referred to as the anti-gay bill. One of the sponsors of this bill is Nelson Roxin. Dafeamekpor, who is with us in the studio, is a member of the Constitutional, Legal and Parliamentary Affairs Committee of Parliament that has been doing quite some work on this bill. So first off, I've seen a story that indicates that this you defer the approval of this anti-gay bill to February 27. True?
Yes, true.
This is the day that the president is expected to deliver the State of the Nation address.
Yes.
Why did you defer it to that day?
Okay. Very simple. We have concluded effectively what we call consideration. That was done last week. Then, sometime before we adjourned last week Friday, the Honorable Afenyomakin, now Majority Leader, gave an indication. In fact, in the course of the consideration, he proposed several amendments, unadvertised amendments, as we call them, but they were shut down by people like me. And so, the rights that he has as a member of the House, gave an indication that he may want to come formally.
They were shut down by you, not the presiding.
No, speaker. But if we vote, if you propose an amendment,
you can argue it.
Yes,
you won't support it.
You rise and say
but
that
the ultimate decision is made by the.
No, the speaker will put the question and then we'll vote.
And then
so
vote.
Once the proposal is lost, the amendment is lost, it can't be carried.
That one I remember.
Yes. So, so he gave the indication that he'll come formally by filing those amendments. So by Monday, I got information that he had filed quite an elaborate number of amendments. So by Tuesday, they were advertised, and they are all here. Mm. So we proceeded to deal with them, but business of the House were such that we couldn't consider. This is a private member's business, so they were not considered. So we proceeded to deal with them on Wednesday.
I see.
So on Wednesday, we began. We began a bit late, some minutes to adjournment. So he was able to move only one amendment, the first one, which got defeated. And the House got adjourned. So on Thursday, we couldn't work on it. Then on Friday, yesterday, we did some work. Now, on Thursday we worked. Now, so he came and sought to move the amendments as advertised in his name. And before you could do that, because we had concluded the second consideration, he proceeded under order 171 rule 1, which says that a member, after the consideration, and with your leave, if I may read,
yes,
for the education of
the viewers.
Yeah. Second consideration of bills, order 171, rule 1, where a member intends to delete, amend, or introduce a provision in a bill which has passed through the consideration stage, the member may, immediately before a sponsor rises to move the motion for the third reading of the bill, move that the bill passes through a second consideration, either wholly or in respect of a particular part or parts of the bill, or some proposed new clause or new schedule.
Mm-hmm.
Now, so this is a motion that you move.
Right.
And he moved the motion, and we all agreed to it. So speaker granted the motion. Now, if you go to rule 4 under order 171, it says this. Where a bill has been ordered, so now it's been ordered in one, that it goes through second consideration.
Mm-hmm.
So where a bill has been ordered to pass through a second consideration in respect of a particular part or parts of the bill or some proposed new clause or new schedule, the House shall consider that relevant provision and any amendment which may be proposed to the bill. So in consonance with this procedure, the Honorable Apenyo Makin filed those proposed amendments, and the House considered it. And all of them, because they were same in terms of content and intent.
Mm-hmm.
So once the first one got shut down, consequentially, there's no way the other 13 will survive.
We're going to, I see.
So procedurally, once he lost the first and the second, Speaker advised him that he should take a cue and gauge the mood of the House and do the needful. So he gave a couple of statements before doing so and said that as a result he was I was trying to push him to say willingly, but he refused to say that he was doing so willingly.
So these two proposals that you shut down, yes, were to do with the replacement of imprisonment,
yes,
of persons found engaging in LGBT activities with community service,
exactly,
for so persons found culpable.
Yes.
And that you shut down.
Yes.
You still want the imprisonment. The imprisonment is still there.
Yes.
It's the punishment, it's
yes,
for persons.
Yes, he was simply making the case that we should avoid imposing a custodial sentence. We should avoid giving the courts the option to impose a custodial sentence, and that we should do non-custodial. And that he thought that it was in line with our new sentencing policy regime. But people like me said, well, that's merely a policy. Indeed, just about a month ago, 6 persons were sentenced to death by hanging for having been found or convicted of having engaged in treasonable conduct. So we can't say that our courts are not want to impose custodial sentence or even the death sentence where applicable. They will when the facts and the evidence placed before them points to that fact. So the courts must have the opportunity to be able to do that. And so, as a result, he lost the all the amendments. So having done that, we as sponsors also had a couple of amendments to tidy up some couple of provisions. And those were done subject to further amendments. It was carried. But if you come to order 172,
mm-hmm,
1, which the head knows is third reading of bills, once you pass consideration, the next stage is third reading, where the bill is passed, is read the third time and passed. But this is what our standing order says. Order 172, rule 1 says, where a bill has passed through.
This is reference to the new standing.
Yes, yes, yes.
This is the new standing, yes,
order. Or the revised standing order. Yes, as you want to call it.
In fact, we'll say that the revised standing order. I like to use the word revised. This is the third edition.
This is why I'm
so,
talking.
Order 172, rule 1. It says, where a bill has passed through the consideration stage, Second consideration is also part of consideration. The third reading shall not be taken until at least one sitting day has elapsed.
Okay.
So this is the provision that prevented us from moving to the third stage yesterday.
So at least a gap of at least one sitting day
must
before
intervene.
The third reading.
Yes.
Okay.
So technically, it will be taken on Wednesday.
Wednesday?
Yes.
Not Tuesday. Okay. So Wednesday, the February 28th.
Yes.
You all things yes, being
pursuant,
equal.
Pursuant to Order 172, Rule 1. But we have a provision in the standing orders which says that notwithstanding, I can move and say that notwithstanding the express terms of Order 172, Rule 1, I will urge the House that so-and-so, motion number so-and-so be taken today. So that in that case, we are asking the Speaker to suspend the operation of that standing order, which is Order 172.1. Okay. Speaker has the power to suspend its effect and so that business can be done. These are technicalities.
Indeed. Yes. Well, so after
but we are careful. We don't, because of some things we are hearing, so we want to do everything.
What are you hearing?
To the letter.
What are you hearing?
Well, a certain declared, anticipated suit in the Supreme Court as soon as it's passed. So we want to do everything in consonance with the procedure. So that we don't breach procedure.
You're picking information that there's someone heading to the Supreme
Court.
Yes,
people are evincing clear intent to go and challenge
this in the Supreme Court.
Legislation, yes.
Okay, so if you after you do your job, let's say all things being equal, Wednesday, you Parliament approves this anti-gay bill, then what?
Then, pursuant to our new standing orders, it will be hitherto we didn't have it. When we pass, once we are done, we leave the work for the back office, the drafters, to tidy up and submit. And we have discovered that on a couple of occasions, things that we thought we had amended or taken out from bills still found their way into the law. Or things that we thought that we had, somebody proposed amendment has been carried, having featured in the law.
Mm-hmm.
So by our revised standing orders, there's a provision where when the consideration is done and a bill is read the third time and passed, the drafters will have to come back with a final draft of all the provisions as variously amended and adopted as forming part of the bill as presented for a small team, a winnowing team, to check as in to audit and verify every key provision. Has been the true reflection of the intent of Parliament in enacting that legislation. Before a transmitter letter will be put on it by the clerk to the office of the president for his assent.
I see. So central to this bill is that what? You can't, or persons who associate with this community cannot do so openly. What they do in their bedrooms, you don't care. This bill doesn't care about what happens in their bedrooms. It is the open promotion of it that this bill seeks to kill.
So is every crime. Every conduct that is criminalized in this country. If you hide in your room and you go and think of overthrowing the Republic, that is your business. But once it is found, once it becomes public knowledge, you'll be dealt with in accordance with the law. If you hide and go and steal and you are not caught, you think you are free. So every single conduct that is criminalized, that is how it is. If you do something in your bedroom that the nation frowns upon and you are not uncovered, you walk. If you jump the traffic light, which is a traffic offense, if you jump the red light and you are not caught, you are off. But when you are caught, you face the full rigor of the law.